Hey, what's up, YouTubers? Today I got a PlayStation 4 with a broken HDMI port. It's a common issue because of how the PlayStation 4, the back is angled. A lot of people plug the HDMI port in wrong. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace the HDMI port on this one. So let's get started. They're gonna remove all these screws. Only gotta take the board out, so. Move the hard drive. We're going to disconnect the cables on the actual CD drive and the power supply. Lift the phone both sides, disconnect the plug. And disconnect the cables from the CD drive, power cable. And the Wi-Fi antenna. Some of the models, they have a screw right here, you gotta disconnect that one. Sometimes that one's a pain in the butt right there. Alright, so what we're gonna do is turn the screws, hold the heat shield on, disconnect the power supply for the fan, and then remove these couple screws. So one more time, make sure we didn't forget to disconnect anything. pull up on this side. And the board. There's the board. Now we're going to remove the actual battery from it. Clean the thermal paste off the CPU. Obviously, we're going to add new thermal paste. Put those back on the shield. Alright, so that's done. Clean it up a little bit. Alright. Now, obviously you can see the port is damaged. Especially at an angle like that. So, what we're going to do is we're going to tape off a couple areas. So you can see that thing's jacked up. Pins are pushed out. Hopefully no pads are torn. Sometimes there's pads that are torn. So we got that taped off. Now I'm going to add a shield to it. protect the RAM. Also, I'm going to take the bottom of the RAM. This stuff does get hot. I'm removing it on the rework station. Also, it's a good idea to put a piece of tape over this. I don't know how the air can get under there. Alright, we're good. What we're going to do is we're going to add some flux. What we're going to do is put it on the machine now. Okay, now I got the machine on. I'm gonna set the machine to pre-warm the board. So we're going to let it pre-warm up.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop that now. The humidity level is way low, so we can stop that. We're gonna select a different profile. I'm gonna add a little bit more flux. Obviously that stuff dried up a little bit. So now I'm gonna start the profile, remove the HDMI port. Alright, we're about halfway point melting. Now this board does take a lot of mass, a lot of heat mass, so it takes a lot to remove them. I'm pretty sure I could do them with the JVC. I have done them with the JVC, but it's just a lot easier doing it this way. Now once it gets shiny and down to melting point, then we're gonna pull HDMI port off, and then we're gonna suck the solder out of the port, the little hole ports that hold the HDMI port in place. Should be about almost there. Okay, now it's at melting point. You can pull the pad. Put a constant temperature. Good, we can stop the profile. I'll come back when it's cooled down. All right, so we're back after the board cooled down. Now you can see we sucked up the solder out of the pockets, but need to wick up a couple pockets there, so that's what we're gonna do now. Thank you.
We're just gonna work some new fresh solder in there. Of course, this wants to be a pain in the butt. Yeah, usually this would have been sucked up, but I had a piece of tape covering it underneath, so left some solder there. There we go, we got them liquefied. A lot easier. Alright, we're good. We should be good. I got this one a little bit better. Alright, we're good. What we're gonna do is just clean up this area. So there's no pads torn, luckily. What I'm going to do is add some fresh solder to these pads, get them all ready and prepped. Up. Add some solder to the pads. Good. Grab a new HDMI port. Most of the time you need something to bend the actual HDMI port legs in place to meet up correctly with the pads. Obviously you can see it doesn't meet up correctly, so we're gonna have to bend adjust it in place. So I'm going to move the pins over slightly, both of them. Move the other ones in. Actually, the wrong way. Almost there. Can't believe these manufacturers are off that much. Should learn how to build the ports the right way. Alright, so we're dead even now. So we can push it in place. Gonna do is I like to do is since we got fresh solder on those pads, I add some flux and then push it down with the hot air station, the hot air tweezers. So you see it's taking the solder of the new pads. Alright, now I just hold it in place, like cool. Now I'm not going to add solder to the four pads that hold it in place just yet, just in case we get solder on these connectors here. So I'm going to add some solder to all little pins. I had to change the soldering irons. Change the tip out. This tip might be a little too small.
tip.
I like the blade tip for this. Obviously, I have bridge connector, so look it up. Add some more flux. Did it again. These two pins are being a pain in the butt for some reason. Alright, should be good except those last four. Join those two too. Just one pin. And there we go. We got them all. Usually it's not that pain in the butt, but for some reason, maybe just because I'm filming it. That's probably why. See, as you see, they're all connected, so now what we'll do. We'll add solder to, or some flux to the side pins, and secure the HDMI port down. It takes a lot of heat too. good. Good. You don't have to make it look pretty. Backside. Alright, good to go. Spin her up a little bit. Make her look pretty. Alright, we're good to go. All we have to do is test her, which she's going to work. As long as there's nothing else wrong with the PlayStation 4. Alright, so what we're gonna do is clean her up a little bit better. Now we're gonna add some thermal paste. Make sure you place the battery back in there. Sucks when you forget and you gotta take it back apart and the battery in there. Alright, now slide it in place. Put it back in the machine. Plastic unit housing. Connect the power to the fan. Place the other shield. Screw it back together. Kind of bend this back a little bit. Connect all the wires. Wi-Fi antenna. Thank you. screw in here. Put the power supply back in. So we're almost done, and then we could test the machine, which it should test fine. Make sure you put the hard drive back in, or else the machine won't even boot up. Gotta grab a power cord. Thank you. now we'll just plug it in, test it. Make sure we get video. Power button. Let her boot up. And as you can see, we have video from the HDMI port replacement. There we go. It's gonna say a screen. Welcome back to your PlayStation 4. So I hope you guys liked the video. Appreciate it if you guys subscribe, like my page. And also give me a thumbs up. Thank you.